Storytelling is so important in this day and age where we're just overloaded with information. For your message to impact someone else, you really have to have a story behind it, right? We can really just use a classic fable, for example, of you know, take your time, be patient, right? Relate it to a story and people really understand that. And you just use it, you know, the classic story, the tortoise and the hare. But I really want to talk about a different type of storytelling. Not one to relate to others to influence them, but the stories that you're telling yourself. Yes, the ones that you're telling yourself right now. I'm looking at you, I'm talking to you because I know exactly what's going on inside between your ears because I have the same exact problems. And these are the stories that are going to limit your performance, they're going to make you unhappy, and they could even eventually lead you to dying early. And you know, I think two things. If you don't live up to your potential, that's a great regret, or if you even die early. And what are these stories that you're telling yourself? And they disguise themselves as stories, and they're really excuses. So I want to go over them. There's five of them. Number one is that everyone else in your industry or what you do, whether you're a business owner, an entrepreneur, you're just highly successful, they work this hard. And you have to do that as well, and you need to sacrifice your health to get there. Look, I've been there myself. I've done that too when I started my own business. Because I thought I could work harder and longer, but as I started to neglect my health, things got worse and worse and worse, and then I could look over my shoulder and see my friends and my colleagues that were doing the same exact thing as I was, but they were making their health a priority, and they were actually making more money and being more successful. So that's number one. The second one is that you're successful because you only sleep 4 or 5 hours a night. Look, just imagine how much more successful you would be if you actually slept those 7, or really the recommended 8 hours that you really need. There's been 50 years of sleep research. You can't deny it, you can't ignore it, okay? It's proven that people that get that higher quality and that quantity of sleep consistently are gonna perform better. They're gonna have more productivity. They're gonna think clearer, and they're gonna be happier in life, and you're no different. The next one I hear all the time, especially right now with the craziness in the world, is I'm going to, you know, give me 90 days. Give me to the end of the month to focus on my health. And you're just pushing it off and neglecting it further and further. And it's not really another 90 days. Look, we'll be real here. It's been years since you've actually felt full of energy and happy and alive. And it's only gonna continue until you finally commit to making your health a priority. And look, once you do, the benefits are just amazing from top to bottom, and you know, you're no different. You can't just keep waiting to put it off. You're just delaying your results and your potential of where you can go. Number four, now this is a great one, is you're just built this way. You're just genetically different where you don't need to make your health a priority. Or even if you were to do it, it wouldn't really make a difference. And look, you can just look on my page, you can look on all of these, you know, all of the people, I mean, you can just go on Facebook or Instagram and see people completely change their physical look on all of these things that they were genetically brought up with, whether they're overweight, diabetes, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, their family gave them to them and they overcame that obstacle, okay? So yes, there is some genetic, you know, disposition of where you are, but all of those factors pretty much, you can change them by what you do and the environment that you're in. So it's not that you're genetically just stuck here. You have an impact on that by what you do every day. And my favorite of all time, of course, is you don't have time for X, right? X is eating healthy, it's exercising, it's making your sleep a priority, like we kind of touched on a little bit earlier, it's drinking water, okay? All of those things, you look at them as they're taking away from your ROI on, you know, your business or whatever it might be, but really if you think about it, if you go and take that time, use it wisely, invest it, okay, in your exercise, in your eating healthy, you have more energy, you come back with a greater focus and a greater determination because you did that for your health, because there's, you know, the research is there. You know, how much more you can improve your BDNF, your brain-derived neurotrophic factor, to really improve learning, okay? Then it's not a cost at all. You are actually, first of all, you're going to look better and feel better, like, just because you did those things. And then you're actually going to get a benefit and a return on your investment from that time. Look, you're not special. You're not different than anyone else, okay? And those stories, I want you to tell me yours below, that you keep telling yourself are only limiting and hurting your performance, okay? It's limiting how much money you can make, your impact that you can provide for your family, and really your impact in this world and your mission going forward. So you need to dump them. You need to dump them right now.